Mary Ann Hansen. I am an extension plant pathologist with Virginia Cooperative Extension and the Virginia Tech Plant Disease Clinic. And today we're going to discuss the disease called boxwood blight. Boxwood enthusiasts are going to want to replace boxwood with boxwood, and that's understandable. And there are many resistant cultivars out there at this point. So, for example, Japanese boxwood cultivar Green Velvet is one that shows good resistance to boxwood blight, as well as a Korean boxwood cultivar called Nana. And some of these newer cultivars have a more open canopy habit, and so you get better air circulation in the canopy, and that's less favorable to the disease. So look for new information. People are still doing research trials to identify resistant cultivars, and there's also information on the Virginia Boxwood Blight Task Force website, a link to some research done at North Carolina State University, and there are lists of some resistant cultivars there. Of course, other people may say, I'm done with boxwood, I just want to plant something that's not susceptible, and anything that's not in the boxwood family would be fine. The problem is that it's really hard to replace the sort of niche that boxwood fills in a landscape planting. There aren't many really nice, slow-growing broadleaf evergreens that can replace boxwood. And a lot of people will try to grow Japanese holly, but that typically gets a root disease called black root rot, so I don't really recommend that species. There are conifers, of course those aren't broadleaf evergreens, but there are, you know, some choices if people would rather stay away from boxwood. There is a lot of ongoing research in boxwood and development of new resistant cultivars, so I think we have every reason to believe that boxwood will remain an important part of our landscapes in Virginia. But if you live in Virginia and you suspect that you may have boxwood blight in your boxwood plants, you can submit a sample for diagnosis through your local county extension office to the Plant Disease Clinic here at Virginia Tech. So what you want to do is collect some symptomatic stems that are not completely dead yet and double bag them, just put them in two, you know, Ziploc type bags, and take them to your local county extension office where you'll fill out a diagnostic form, and then the sample can be sent to our lab here at Virginia Tech, and we will determine whether boxwood blight is present or not. Now, if you have a root problem, a stem sample won't be adequate, and so you may need to include a root and soil sample. And in that case, you'd also want to submit a large handful of fibrous roots in a plastic bag in at least 1 pint of soil. But basically, the quicker we're able to diagnose boxwood blight, the better we will be able to prevent spread in Virginia landscapes.